Ok, muchas gracias. Bien, pues bienvenidos todos a este encuentro universitario que la Universidad Pedagógica de Durango ha organizado para ustedes. En este espacio vamos a compartir los trabajos finales o una parte de los trabajos finales que los chicos de licenciatura hicieron para su clase de inglés, donde vamos a poder ver un poco del trabajo que realizaron. Vamos a ver nueve partes de los nueve videos que hemos recibido de las distintas clases de los distintos maestros. Y bueno, el motivo principal es que para que podamos motivarnos y poder ver la importancia del inglés y cómo paso a paso podemos ir avanzando. Tenemos también, se encuentran con nosotros también algunos alumnos de la licenciatura en ciencias que están en Dallas, que están en Texas, y entonces para ellos también es como importante el ver el trabajo que ustedes realizan como parte de su clase de inglés. Ya el inglés no es un hobby, ya no es a ver quién quiere estudiar, es una necesidad real, y ustedes como próximos profesionistas de la educación verán que es de suma importancia. Agradezco a todos los presentes, ahorita los vamos a presentar, a los alumnos, a los maestros de las diferentes clases de inglés que el día de hoy nos acompañan. Le damos la más cordial bienvenida a nuestras autoridades, a los presentadores y a los demás compañeros, maestros y alumnos que nos honran con su presencia. Le damos la más cordial bienvenida a la doctora Alejandra Méndez Zúñiga, la secretaria académica de nuestra universidad, a la doctora Deleinés Ceniceros Cázares, coordinadora de la licenciatura en intervención educativa, al maestro Juan Saucedo, coordinador de la licenciatura en ciencias de la educación, y a los demás maestros que conforman la Academia de Inglés de las diferentes licenciaturas. Muy bienvenidos sean todos y esperemos que podamos apreciar un poco del trabajo que hacen los alumnos, que es bastante. Esperamos en algún momento más que nuestro rector, el doctor José Germán Reyes Lozano, se pueda integrar y nos compartirá algunas palabras. Mientras continuamos. Always do your best. What you plan now, you will harvest later. O.J. Mandino. Cedo la palabra en este momento a la maestra Karina Fernández, coordinadora del programa de inglés a nivel licenciatura, quien nos hablará sobre la exposición de motivos de esta presentación. Adelante, maestra.
Gracias, maestra Ana. Aprender otro idioma no es solamente aprender palabras diferentes para las mismas cosas, sino aprender otra manera de pensar acerca de las cosas. Flora Luis. Bienvenidos a la presentación de proyectos finales del programa de inglés de la Universidad Pedagógica de Durango. Saludo a las autoridades educativas que nos acompañan o que se integrarán más adelante el día de hoy. El rector de la universidad, el doctor Germán Lozano Reyes, la doctora Alejandra Méndez Zúñiga, secretaria académica de la universidad, a la coordinadora de la licenciatura en intervención educativa, la maestra Deleinés Ceniceros Cázares, al coordinador de la licenciatura en ciencias de la educación, el maestro Juan Saucedo Barragán, y demás autoridades presentes. Muchas gracias. El día de hoy se presentarán algunos de los proyectos finales realizados por los alumnos del programa de inglés. Estos videos son fragmentos de dichos proyectos que no serán transmitidos en su totalidad por cuestiones de tiempo, pero que representan algo del trabajo realizado por maestros y alumnos durante este semestre. Tenemos una pequeña parte nada más de estos videos y pocos videos porque realmente pues tenemos muchos grupos de inglés ya en la universidad y no es posible presentar todos sus trabajos finales, pero vamos a tratar también de difundirlos de otras formas. Es importante reconocer este trabajo y esfuerzo mostrado por nuestros alumnos y maestros durante este periodo en línea, que a pesar de no encontrarnos en la modalidad habitual, cumplieron con los objetivos establecidos en los programas. No han sido momentos fáciles para ninguno de nosotros, pero la perseverancia y compromiso de nuestros estudiantes nos han permitido concluir este semestre de manera satisfactoria. El programa de inglés de la universidad está enfocado en fortalecer y desarrollar las competencias comunicativas en los alumnos. Es por eso que los proyectos finales se centran en posicionar al alumno en una situación real de comunicación, en la que todo el aprendizaje sea aplicado y se logre la comunicación, que es el objetivo principal de aprender un nuevo idioma. The English language is actually considered the most important language in the world. It is an excellent tool that can offer different kinds of opportunities. It is an advantage in the professional field and a cultural resource that allows students increased knowledge and competences that will be really useful for them as future teachers. Learning any language also provides the possibility to improve cognitive skills and a great deal of benefits. Having said that, we encourage to all our students to continue learning and increasing your possibilities. Thank you, Ana.
Thank you, teacher. So we are going to continue, and now we are going to present our students, our teachers, and we are going to present part of areas. Okay, in first place we have of the teacher Carlos Flores, the student Carolina Enriquez with her video Morning Show. Carolina, if you want to present your video.
Yes, hello. Good afternoon. My name is Carolina and my English teacher is Mr. Carlos. My classmates and I have been working with him this semester. It's been a really nice journey. He has been really patient with us. Every time that we have questions for him, he's always answering the questions for us. When I made this video, it was really challenging for me. I was so nervous. I have so much bloopers of it, but I had so much fun making it. And I have, I know that my classmates have so much fun as well. So now as an example of the final product that we learned in this course, I'm going to present a section of our video with my classmate Ursula, who's talking about sports in our newscast. So I hope you guys enjoy it. Thank you. So just enjoy the video. Thank you very much. This is a part of her video. Later, you can be able to watch the full videos in our Facebook page.
No, se están hablando como no.
Okay, next.
Ya, pues déjalo que se oiga. Y la cámara aquí, ¿cómo se ve? Si está prendida o no.
Wait a second, please. Okay, wait. Next we have Adriana Valdivia Abdil.
Yes. My classmate, Diana, and I, I'm project talking about South Korea. I personally talk about the language, Korean, some tradition and custom, and the food. The Korean language is the written in syllable blocks with each alphabet is written vertically or horizontally. The most striking food in South Korea is kimchi. My classmate talks about the weather in South Korea where it is his favorite in the spring. He also talks about K-pop and the fam of South Korea. I hope you enjoy the video.
Thank you. Her teacher is Evelyn Montaño. Let's watch the video.
Miss, disculpe, el video no se escucha. A ver, este video sí se escuchó más o menos o no?
No, muy bien.
Escucha, maestra Ana, nada más hay que subir el volumen de su computadora para que la transmisión a nosotros nos llegue con mejor volumen.
Maestra, me parece que en la opción de compartir pantalla hay una opción que se llama compartir sonido también. Entonces así se va a escuchar mejor.
Ok, a ver, voy a volver a poner el video anterior y me dicen si se escucha, ¿sí?
A lo mejor podríamos compartir, maestra, nuevamente dejar de compartir y luego compartir, pero con la casilla esa de audio que comenta el compañero.
Ok. Voy a regresar entonces al primer video y me dicen, ya le puse esa opción para ver si se escucha mejor el sonido. Este video sí tiene un poquito bajito el video, el sonido. Ya venía así, vamos a ver si se escucha mejor.
Hello, good morning everyone. On sports, we had the 2021 NFL schedule. This schedule was officially released on Wednesday night. It will be the first time in
the season that the NFL will have an 18-season.
The official vote to add another
game
in the schedule for the playoff. Tom Brady
and
Tampa Bay are the defending that Super Bowl will be the champion.
Gracias. De todas maneras, les recuerdo que los videos completos los estaremos pasando por la página de Facebook de la universidad para que podamos ver completos. Voy a volver a pasar el segundo de Adriana para que se escuche mejor.
My team and I will introduce the country of South Korea. I will start with your language.
The Korean language.
Korean is spoken in 98% of the population. South Korea is different from North Korean in pronunciation, grammar, lexicon, and writing. It is writing using its own alphabet, angle with.
What is in South Korea? The climate of the East Monsoon temperate. The best months the visit South Korea are the spring, is April, and May.
What other non-official language are spoken in South Korea? In education, English a compulsory subject, while Japanese or Mandarin Chinese are optional. Aproximadamente. Of the South Korean population can speak English well.
¿Pudiste conectar?
Sí, pero.
¿Quieres los audífonos?
No, déjalo lo que quiero.
No es K-pop. It's a lot to K-pop become some because of the song campaign within the only thing that is K-pop is such listen to thanks to the South Korean group BTS.
Okay, sorry for the delay and the sound problems. Okay, next one is, the video is from Julia Guadalupe Murguía Valdez and her video is talk show. Her teacher is Miguel Flores.
Hello, my name is Julia Murguía. I am going to tell you a little about this semester in the English course. Main we learn to introduce yourself, to talk about preference, to make comparisons, to ask questions about other people's jobs, and to make questions and answer using the verb to be. We use all these topics in our final project, which is a talk show where we're interviewed. My team and I characterized ourselves to be interviewers, presenters, and guests. It was a very fun to do it. I hope you like it.
Hello, everyone. We are today with a super singer, Selena Gomez. Welcome. How are you? It's a pleasure to be here.
Hi, I am very fine. I am very excited because this is a new experience.
Tell me about how you stay in music.
Well, I love to sing since I was little. I always saw my mom prepare for her show. And I think that's how my taste was born. I started preparing and enjoyed children's show.
Now I will ask you more personal question, and that perhaps no one else I ask it you.
It's okay, I am prepared.
What is your favorite snack?
Okay, it's a true question, picking just one out of many. But I think oatmeal cookies.
Oh, it's interesting.
It's easy to do. I could give you the recipe right now if you want it.
Of course, yes. They use how you prepare.
Okay, first I'll place the oatmeal in the blender. It's turned to dust. After that, they are placing the anger.
How do they celebrate Easter?
Well, when it's Christmas, we usually meet, but before we meet, we usually have a secret friend. We give him gift, and after dinner, we give a final gift for knowing who was the person who gave you the cold time.
Selena, was a pleasure to have you here with me. I hope every time goes very well in the show. Bye.
Thanks.
Okay, next we have William Octavio Garcia Franco with his video podcast, Special Gift. His teacher is Elisa Cimental.
Disculpe, creo que hubo un error porque el video pasado era de otra compañera y mío, de la teacher Diana Díaz.
Ah, ok. Espérenme. Tienen razón. El video pasado era de Ayelín, Elizabeth Salcedo y Ana Laura Valenzuela. El talk show con la maestra Diana Díaz, ¿correcto?
Es que aquí está.
A ver, Ayelín.
Okay, it's Ana Laura who is presenting. As we already saw the video, I think Ana Laura, just tell us about what you and your partner just did, so we can have an idea of what we saw.
Yes, thank you. We saw the interview with Selena Gomez, right?
¿Qué quiere?
Very good, thank you. Okay. So next one is going to be Julia Guadalupe Murguía.
Ana.
Acá por la Zacatecas venden lomos y lomos
fritos.
Sí, es Julia Guadalupe Murguía del profesor Miguel Párez.
Nuestro video.
Sí,
okay. Sí, ese es el video.
Ok, si gustan presentarlo ahora, por favor. Julia.
Hello, my name is Julia Murguía. I am going to tell you a little about what we learned this semester in the English course. Main, we learned to introduce yourself, to talk about preference, to make comparisons, to ask questions and answers using the verb to be. We use all these topics in our final project, which a talk show where we interviewed Hash. My team and I characterized ourselves to be interviewers, presenters, and guests. It was very fun to do it. I hope you like it.
We are very happy to have these two great singers on the show. Thank you very much for being here in the program.
Today, we will have a wonderful program with two great artists who are also sisters. As Jamie already mentioned, we have Hash with us. We have some questions to get something better. They are things that the public would love to know, and some others of the day I have done.
Hannah and Ashley are two sisters who sound deposited.
No, güey.
Se paró el video, ¿verdad?
Dígame. Sí.
Si hay algún problema con la presentación del video, yo lo puedo pasar, el de mi alumna Julia.
Sí, por favor, porque estoy teniendo aquí complicaciones con el internet.
De acuerdo, enseguida les comparto el video.
Gracias.
We are very happy to have these two great singers on the show. Thank you very much for being here in the program.
Today, we will have a wonderful program with two great artists who are also sisters. As Jamie already mentioned, we have Hash with us. We have some questions to get something better. They are things that the public would love to know, and some others of the day I have done.
Hannah and Ashley are two sisters who sound deposited Dream and Size 2002. They founded this country pop duo called Hash, since they joined the first letters of their name.
Hello, we are very excited to be here today.
Take us about you. Where are they from?
We are from Lake Charles, Louisiana, United States of America.
Achieve our dreams? What encouraged you to sing?
Our family. They were always there to support and motivate us to be better.
What don't you like about Finn?
Maybe the privacy part. All of this changed completely for the worse.
Now, before the end, you are a great artist. So, in addition to having an excellent voice, do you play an instrument?
Yes, I know how to play the guitar. It is something that I really like me.
Yes, I love it. Play the guitar. It's my favorite hobby.
It's a wonderful and true honor to have Hannah and Ashley with us today.
Okay, so it finished here. Aquí termina el video.
Gracias, Maestro Miguel. Antes de continuar, nada más darle la palabra a Yelena Elizabeth Salcedo, Nava y Ana Laura, que faltaron de presentar su video. Ya lo vimos, fue el segundo video, el Tall Show. Adelante a Yelena Elizabeth y Ana Laura. Queremos escuchar la explicación de su video, chicas. Que parece que tienen problemas con conexión. Esperamos un momento para esperar que estén conectadas y por lo pronto seguimos con el video de William Octavio García Franco, que es un podcast, es un podcast special gift, that's the topic of the podcast. The teacher is Elisa Cimental and Miguel is gonna present the video.
Okay, so I'm going to share my screen once William ends, okay?
Okay. William, you can talk about your video now.
Hola, tengo buen audio. ¿Sí me escuchan?
Sí, sí te escuchamos. Adelante.
Yo tenía, ya lo pagué.
Cámara.
Te lo mereces enseñar a papá. Localidad.
Güey, ya me están reclamando en el grupo.
Vamos a escuchar a William y a apagar los demás, todos los micrófonos, los que tenemos prendido micrófono para poder escucharte. Adelante, William.
Okay. Good afternoon to all. My name is William, LCE first semester student. Well, for a word, we are based on analyzing the previous activities carried on the class and as a task. These activities we're helping throughout the semester, and that was how we make the work. The word is to make up story in an original way and with dialogues that include all 10 members. The words were simple and a lot of learning. I say this because when carrying out the story, technology already acquired and the ability of understanding and fluency of the language was improved. In general, all the word was helpful. We have a start, a theme, and conclusion. Say that I have nothing left to give thanks for the study of topics and knowledge accurate, as well as giving thanks to our teacher for always being able about the both jobs and review of jobs. Well, as you say, thank you very much.
Once upon a time, there was a small town farmer named Betty. Betty was like every day working from the 8:30 a.m. planning the activities of the day when she realized one thing. She did not have much food for her chickens, and it was then that she decided to go to town to look for food for her animals. When she was walking into town, she met her friend Sam on the road, and they started a chat.
Good morning, Betty. How are you?
Hi, Sam. Very good, thanks. And you?
Very good. Wow, what did you take your hand?
It's a watch. My dad gave it to me for birthday, and he told me that he has a special power. But I don't know what that power is.
At the moment, Sam touches Betty's watch and say,
"Watch, if you are magic or special, show you your power, please."
After that, the cloud glowed with colored lights, and I teleported Betty and Sam to Betty's farm. They waved both pocket and decided to run with her friend Ben. He told her news.
Okay, very good, guys. Excellent job. No nos queremos ir sin escuchar a Ana Laura, que ya parece que está lista con la explicación del video, del segundo video que vimos. Y bueno, queremos escucharte, Ana Laura. Adelante.
Hi, thank you. My name is Ana Laura. My partner is Ayolín Salcedo. For example, we saw the use of expression to evaluate the service that our city offers. We learned the correct use of too many, too much, fewer, less, etc. Also, we learned to advise about what a person should take or should not forget when visiting some place. Besides, we know ways to make requests for information or actions. We check the different customs and holidays around all the world, as well as the local ones. Our final project is a representation of some of the knowledge we got. In the video you are about to see, we try to simulate a talk show with Selena Gomez. My partner acted as the interviewer and I represented Selena Gomez. The grammar we employed was the past tense to talk about her childhood, the sequence of verbs to refer to her favorite snack, comparison with nouns to talk about her lifestyle changes, and finally, we use the adverbial class of times, when, after, and before, to talk about the way Selena celebrates different holidays. Thank you.
Excellent explanation, Ana Laura. Very good. And your video was really great. Thank you for your explanation. Now we will continue with Alejandra Faudoa Diaz, and they're going to present a video about a recipe. So first, let's listen to Alejandra, your explanation about the video. Alejandra, go ahead.
Good afternoon. My name is Alejandra Faudoa Diaz, and my teacher is Paola Contreras. What I learned with this project was how to follow steps and the time of making a recipe, the connectors of sequence, and the most important, how to make one. I decided to make enchiladas verdes because it's my favorite Mexican plate.
Hi, I hope you are well. My name is Alejandra, and today I am going to teach you how to make enchiladas verdes, a typical Mexican dish, easy and delicious. The ingredients that we will use are 3 ancho chili peppers, 2 tomatillos, 1 jalapeño, half an onion, 1 clove garlic, half a tablespoon of pepper, 1 North Suiza, shredded chicken, 1/4 of cream of your preference, cheese, salt, milk, oil, and tortillas. Utensils: cooking pot, pan, cheese grater, fork, big and small spoon. First, you must add water to pot and the cooked chilies, tomatillos, and onion. Then we put them to soak. Put the grated cheese on top. Thus ending our recipe. If you like, accompany them with rice. Goodbye.
Okay, sorry guys, I was with my microphone muted. Thank you very much, Alejandra Faudoa. You did it really good. That was an excellent presentation. You can see now that you we're having different kinds of videos or different kinds of final projects because we have different levels. So the students are applying different kinds of competences, communicative competences, and they're doing it really good. So let's continue then with Héctor Victorio Roldán and Andrea González Correa. They're going to present an historical interview video. So this is going to be really interesting. Go ahead, Héctor Victorio and Alejandra González.
Do you want to say something, guys, first of all?
Hello, everyone. For us, it is a pleasure to share a little bit of all the knowledge we acquired during this time.
We learn how to interact using the second language by giving opinion about things we like or not.
We also learning how to describe future events and even make plans using it. It is important to mention that we learn how to talk about plans, even as historical characters.
In brief, English is not a subject. We learn a second language gives us the opportunity to connect with more people around the world.
I think it's excellent, and I will try.
As you are a person well known for your political life, but not for what is beyond you, Adolf, on this occasion, we want you to share with us events for your personal life, things that very few know.
I think it's excellent, and I will try to answer all the questions for you.
So let's start. Let's talk a little bit about what your childhood was like. What were your dreams as a child, or what did you want to do when you were up?
As a child, I always liked to draw landscapes and cities, so I wanted to go to art school, but my parents denied me that opportunity because they wanted me to be a military man. In fact, I did try to enter art school, but everyone doubted my talent.
Well, I imagine that must have affected you personally a lot.
Yeah, it really did.
And well, I suppose you have suffered numerous accidents during your life. Could you mention some of the accidents that have marked you the most?
Well, I have suffered many accidents. The first one, remember, I was 4 years old. I almost drowned. Only that a priest from a church saved my life. Then in the First World War, during the war, I was the victim of gas attack that left me temporarily blind.
Whoa, I imagine you live every day surviving from all this.
Exactly, there is no tomorrow for anyone.
And how did you manage to win Germany's trust?
Well, I exceeded Germany's expectation of me and even exceeded those of other mandates.
And how did you do it?
Well, when I started with my party, I saw to increase the German economy. When I got my mandate, I was the first to defend animal rights. That's why I'm a vegetarian, but I never forced my soldiers to be vegetarian. And I also been in human zoos.
Well, Adolf, excellent answers. We were delighted to have you as our guest, and we thank you for your time.
It was a pleasure, and I appreciate the space in this program to talk about my life. See you later.
Bye. Well, we conclude this program with the extraordinary character, and see you next week.
Very good, guys. That was a really creative interview. Well done. And now we're going to continue with Ludy Carrillo. She's going to present a GPS location and directions applied to that. Okay, so we're going to first listen to the explanation of Ludy Carrillo, whose teacher is Emmanuel Ramos.
Hello, good afternoon. My name is Ludy Carrillo. My teacher is Emmanuel Ramos. I'm second semester in the group G. I'm a student, a bachelor degree in Ciencias de la Educación. This project is about a GPS that assists you to get someplace you can visit in Durango City. With this project felt very good because I like to know new place that know everyone knows and share this place with tourists. It's very cool. I like the experience I have during the course and personally, I have great progress. Thank you.
Okay, guys. Well, thank you so much. And I really appreciate that we as the commitment belonging to the English coordination, we had this chance to share with you the greatest things that our students can perform. So let me show you what my dear.
In the side, there is a beautiful place known as Saltito, where there is a beautiful waterfall of more than 20 meters high. Pleasant cowboy and Indian show seems an excellent option for families to have food and to get Museo de la Ciudad from La Camioneta is necessary. Have software on.
Okay, sorry.
In the side, there is a beautiful place known as El Saltito, where there is a beautiful waterfall of more than 20 meters high. To get Museo de la Ciudad from La Camioneta is necessary. Have software on Boulevard Francisco Villa, Mexico, 40 Camioneta 19 meters per kilometer. Turn left and you are getting 20 November 20 meters and you are at your destination.
Thank you. That was it.
Gracias, Emmanuel, por tu presentación. Recuerden que todos los videos completos, les recordamos, los vamos a ver en la página de Facebook de nuestra universidad. Tenemos ahora, contamos con la presencia de nuestro rector, el doctor José Germán Reyes, para que nos dé unas palabras, por favor, rector.
Lozano Reyes.
Ah, perdón, Lozano Reyes.
Good afternoon, my dear students. I'm very happy to say hello to you and very proud to listen your English expositions. I think, I'm sure you are very good in the English oral expression. And in this Congress, Student Congress, this is a very good opportunity to you. To demonstrate your skills and all your, the knowledge you have. Is for me and for all the university community to listen what the good is your exposition and your speaking and your listening. So I'm sure the classes you are receiving are so good as you are in this level. All the videos you presented exposes the Durango culture and is one of the themes of this student congress. So a part of your skills, also your ability to present the culture of Durango is well. So this is only what I can to say to you, and I hope soonly being salutating you with an embrace and holding of our arms. So thank you very much, Anita Nasser. Thank you for being our teacher class, and of course, Karina, who is the coordinator. So really, we feel very proud of you. Thank you very much, and have a nice day. Thank you.
Thank you very much to our principal. Thank you for being here, and we are doing our best effort. Thank you for the teachers and for our students. Thank you, principal. See you later.
Thank you very much. So we will continue with the last video that is from Perla Yareli Diaz Nunez. She is going to explain this recipe to us, and please, Perla, tell us about it.
Good afternoon. My name is Yareli Diaz. I belong to the group ADOS Mixto Escolarizado. I'm studying a degree in educational science. For our final project, we did a recipe video and a small paragraph. The recipe project tries to get you familiarized with the English language in an easier, more creative and more practical way. It is related to what we saw in class, and we make use of different topics, kitchen vocabulary, connectors and sequencers, and understanding the correct use of each one. As for the other project of our favorite subject, it was interesting. We wrote a small paragraph about what our favorite topic was and why we found it useful. This project is meant to help other people who want to start learning English. It may you realize that we must improve and that we must continue learning as we have done so far. Broad projects are important, each one with the same function of facilitating learning.
Hello, my name is Perla Yarelides Núñez. I'm a student Bachelor of Science in Education at the Pedagogical University of Durango. Let's start with the video. Ingredients. 1 stick of unsalted butter melted, 1 egg, 1 cup normal sugar, 1 cup brown sugar, 1 cup chocolate chips, 1 and a half cup wheat flour, 1 tablespoon vanilla essence, 1 teaspoonful baking dust, 1 pinch of salt. Preparation. First, in a bowl, we add all the ingredients, but only half of the chocolate chips, and mix until a homogeneous mass is made. After the dough is ready, we will spread it on the table. Then, using cookie cutters, we are going to cut the cookies into the shapes we want. If you do not have cookie cutters, you can use a spoon to make a small balls. While we cut our cookie shapes, we are going to preheat the oven to 180 degrees. Before putting the cookies in the oven, since they are in the tray or dish in which they are going to be baked, we are going to put half of the remaining chocolate chips on top. The cookies will be in the oven for 10 to 15 minutes.
A few moments later.
If the minutes go by, the cookies will appear slightly golden and will be a little soft.
A few moments later.
And voila, you can finally enjoy them.
Well, thank you. That was delicious. Thank you very much. Okay, guys, so to finish with this event, it is important also to listen to your teachers, okay? So in order to do so, we're going to go with Miguel Flores, that is an English teacher from the English program here in the university. Let's listen to what he has to say. Go ahead, Miguel.
Thank you, Karina. Okay, so hello, everybody. Some of you already know me, and some of you don't. My name is Miguel Flores, and I'm also a teacher from U School. Okay, so I'm going to cite some things that the rector said that was that I'm also very proud to see all of your projects. I'm very happy to see that all of you have a progress and that you can actually show what you learned in the semester. Okay, so today I'm here to give you a little speech about our experience as teachers during the pandemic times and the challenges we had to face in this totally new situation for all of us. Okay, vamos a cambiarlo a español. Okay. Primero que nada, quiero iniciar con un cálido saludo a nuestras autoridades. No estoy seguro de que aún estén aquí con nosotros, pero extiendo ese saludo a ellos. También quiero dar un saludo a mis compañeros de la Academia de Inglés y a todos nuestros alumnos, ustedes, que nos están mirando en este momento. Durante estos tres semestres, que hemos estado llevando esta nueva modalidad de clases a distancia, nos hemos enfrentado a una gran variedad de situaciones que era poco común encontrar durante las clases presenciales. Muchos de nosotros nunca imaginamos que esto podría pasar. Sin embargo, sucedió. Y fue algo a lo que tuvimos que adaptarnos, aunque fuera siquiera por un corto tiempo. Esta pandemia nos vino a enseñar, nos vino a recordar que los maestros también necesitamos tiempo para aprender. No solamente estar enfrente del pizarrón. Estoy seguro de que hablo por muchos cuando digo que aprendimos demasiadas cosas durante este año y medio. Personalmente, aprendí a utilizar varias plataformas que previamente, la verdad, nunca había tenido la necesidad de utilizar. Ustedes las conocerán y a lo mejor cuando las escuchan dicen, ay, pero pues es Classroom, Drive, Schoology. Ya se acordarán de eso en unos años. Como maestros, tuvimos que adaptarnos a integrar las tecnologías a nuestras actividades y usarlas de manera efectiva para lograr los aprendizajes necesarios. También tuvimos que innovarnos a nosotros mismos y a aquellas metodologías que empleamos con tal de lograr sembrar algo en ustedes, nuestros estudiantes. Con que se vayan con el verb to be, ahí ya es algo. Reconozco que todo esto no ha sido una tarea sencilla de realizar, tanto para nosotros los profesores como para ustedes los alumnos. No todos teníamos la preparación para llevar las clases a un ambiente virtual y hacerlas igual de efectivas que cuando solíamos estar en la escuela. Esto, bueno, hablando de los maestros. Por el otro lado, sabemos y estamos conscientes de que no todos nuestros alumnos viven en igualdad de situaciones y de recursos. Esto sabemos muy bien que también fue algo impactante para ustedes. A pesar de todas estas barreras que nos pudimos haber encontrado y que de hecho nos encontramos, supimos hallar el camino y además practicar nuestra paciencia, tanto nosotros con ustedes y ustedes con nosotros, nuestra empatía, para poder lograr los productos que acabamos de ver. La verdad fue un placer para mí y para la Academia de Inglés haberles presentado los resultados que ustedes dieron con todos los aprendizajes que dieron en este semestre, chicos. Muchas felicidades.
Gracias, Miguel. Y bueno, continuando con el mensaje ahora en español, me sumo a la felicitación de Miguel para ustedes, alumnos. Realmente sus presentaciones nos sorprenden porque sabemos que estamos en esta modalidad remota en la que pues no estamos acostumbrados a trabajar y sin embargo vemos que ustedes aprendieron y eso nos llena de orgullo realmente y reconocerles el esfuerzo que han mostrado. De verdad que sus proyectos están muy bien. No podemos presentar los proyectos de todos los grupos, elegimos solo algunos, pero hay muchos proyectos, hay muy buenos. En cada uno de los grupos hubo varios proyectos. Cada uno de estos proyectos son distintos porque están acoplados al nivel de competencias comunicativas que ustedes tenían que demostrar. Felicito también a los alumnos que hicieron la presentación de ese video porque realmente lo hicieron muy bien, hablaron muy bien. Podemos ver que su nivel de inglés está aumentando, que estamos logrando algo, que de verdad el programa de inglés está avanzando junto con ustedes y queremos continuar haciéndolo. Esperemos que la modalidad cambie o que si no cambia, bueno, podamos nosotros tomar la experiencia de estos momentos que hemos vivido para mejorar aún más la práctica docente y que ustedes puedan aprovechar mucho más este programa de inglés de su universidad. Y bueno, pues continuar el siguiente semestre. Felicidades porque terminamos así el programa de inglés, terminamos este semestre y los vamos a ver el siguiente para, bueno, continuar y seguir avanzando con ustedes. Cedo la palabra a la maestra Ana para que finalice con nuestro evento. Muchas gracias a todos. Gracias a los maestros también del programa de inglés y un reconocimiento al trabajo de todos. Gracias.
Muchas gracias, maestra Karina. Un especial agradecimiento para ti y para todos los maestros que han estado al pendiente de nuestros alumnos. Han sido, como dice el maestro Miguel, pues unos retos diferentes, tanto para los alumnos como para los maestros, pero pues aquí podemos ver una prueba de que se puede y de que pues el trabajo aquí está y que podemos seguir haciéndolo. Muchísimas gracias. Con esto damos por terminado nuestra presentación. Les recuerdo, podremos ver los videos más tarde. Compartan en sus redes sociales el link del evento. Ahí está en la página de la universidad para que puedan ir compartiendo. Tenemos presentaciones de películas, entonces ahí podrán acceder para ver las películas. El día de hoy a las 4 de la tarde tenemos nuestra macro clase Respira y Relájate, que podrán ingresar en este mismo link o que podrán ver en la página de Facebook. A las 5 de la tarde tendremos la conferencia interactiva Identidad, Cultura y Gastronomía Local a cargo del Conservatorio de la Cultura Gastronómica de Durango, también en este mismo link y en Facebook Live. Y a partir de las 7 de la tarde tenemos los talleres simultáneos que ustedes ya en los correos tienen sus links para entrar y tendremos estos talleres. Y el día de mañana iniciamos a las 9 de la mañana para nuestros talleres, para los concursos, la presentación de un libro y seguimos con la proyección de películas. Entonces, muchísimas gracias a todos por haber estado, por compartir sus experiencias y a seguir trabajando. Thank you very much. See you next time.
Gracias.
Thank you.
Hola.
Gracias, muchísimas felicidades. Hola. Gracias, nos vemos más tarde.
Diles hello.
Bye bye.
Gracias.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.